The latest version of SQL Server as of now is SQL Server 2016, and it is supported by Blue Prism. However, as I'm using Windows 7, which doesn't support SQL Server 2016, I'm going to use SQL Server 2014 Express Edition. In order to download it, go to Microsoft.com and search for SQL Server 2014 Express. From the search results, click the second option, which is Microsoft SQL Server 2014 Service Pack 2 Express. Now click the download button and choose SQL Express 32-bit or 64-bit depending on your operating system. Then click next and the download should begin. I have already downloaded this and have it on my computer, so let me go ahead and install it. To begin the installation, double click the setup file, click yes, then click OK, and it'll begin the extraction of the setup file. Once that is completed, you will get the SQL Server Installation Center. Click the first option, New SQL Server Standalone Installation or Add Features to an Existing Installation. Read the license terms and click I accept the license terms. The second checkbox, which says Turn on Customer Experience Improvement Program, is optional. I usually leave it unchecked for test environment, but if you want, you may select it. Then click Next. It is recommended to check for Microsoft updates, so I'm going to check this and click Next. And next, I'll leave the named instance as SQL Express. If you want to change it, you can very well do that, but you should be using this name later when configuring Blue Prism. And click Next. Now here, we need the SQL Server browser service to start up automatically as it is required by Blue Prism. So I'm going to change the startup type to automatic and then click Next. I'll leave the authentication mode to Windows and leave other settings as default and click Next, and the installation will continue. This will take a few minutes, so I'm going to fast forward this video. Alright, so the installation of SQL Server 2014 Express Edition is completed and you can close this window. In the next video, I'm going to show you how to configure SQL Server for installing Blue Prism.